If you could solve one problem, an academic one, so not let's take off the table world hunger or peace and so on, which one, and so this includes a hard problem of consciousness or philosophical problems as well as physics ones, which one do you most want solved by you?
Well, it's interesting. And part of my answer will depend on what the answer is. So I think that the solution to the hard problem of consciousness, I suspect it's not going to be very interesting. I suspect that the solution to the hard problem of consciousness will be consciousness just is. It's a quality that emerges when matter takes on a particular organized form and undergoes certain very orderly and organized procedures and phenomenon. And if that's the answer, and I think that is likely to be the answer, then count me out in terms of wanting to solve it. I think that may be the solution. If it's more interesting than that, if there's some consciousness field that, you know, various religions talk about or something that we can't even imagine, and that's the root of consciousness, yes, then I'd love to be part of the journey to solve it that way. But assuming that it's the more boring, but nevertheless, you know, profoundly important solution on what the hard problem is, then the other questions that I would really love to be part of finding the solution of is, what is time? Is it just a secondary feature of the world that we human beings find useful in order to organize our perceptions of the world? Or is time more fundamentally woven into the fabric of reality? You know, is there a realm of reality in which there's no conception of time because the conditions simply have not gelled to the point where a conception of time can even emerge? Or is there always a notion of time because it's just fundamentally part of how reality is constructed? I'd say that would be the one big one. And then allied with that, you know, look, I'd love to know what the unified theory is, right? I'd love to know what 1,000 years from now, kindergartners are going to learn in their course on unified field theory, if that's the answer. You know, what is it and where does it come from? We can have a final theory, whatever it is, general relativity plus quantum mechanics, or maybe it's radically different, but whatever that ultimate theory is, where did it come from? Did someone in some super simulation dream it up and we are just living out? Or where in the world do these fundamental laws and regularities and patterns come from? In essence, really, why is there something rather than nothing? I mean, can't really get deeper than that. And by nothing, I don't mean, you know, empty space. I don't mean nothing in the sense of a void. I mean, truly nothing. No space, no time, no quantum mechanics, no mathematics, no Platonic realm. Like, why isn't there nothing? It seems that there could be nothing. So how did it transpire that there is a something? That's the big one.
Do you think that a true toe or a good toe is one that explains itself?
Well, whenever you talk about a theory of everything, and let me, I will frame it that way. I never use the word toe myself, but you know, whenever you talk about a theory of everything, you have to say to yourself, what is embraced by everything? Usually when we physicists throw around the term theory of everything, we usually mean it in a very limited everything. We usually mean, you know, the particles and the laws, you know, the ingredients and the rules. That's what we mean by everything. But given that, one can say, but why are there any particles? Why are there any rules? And so, yeah, your way of framing it, that if that theory of everything could somehow establish its own inevitability, if that theory of everything somehow has built within it that the lack of existence of that theory of everything would somehow be itself a logical inconsistency, so that reality could not have this theory of everything because reality is, we believe, in some sense consistent, that would That would be deeply compelling.
Dyson conjectured that the Gödel incompleteness theorem, or one of them, applied to physics, and so we may never know a toe. I don't recall his argument, but I'm sure you've heard an argument akin to this. Can you spell it out for the audience, and then where do you stand on it?
You know, I have to say, I have struggled myself for a long time to really know, or at least have a feel for the relevance of Gödel's ideas when it comes to the laws of physics. And there was a time when I tried to convince myself that because Gödel's theorem itself relies upon assumptions, could we modify the assumptions in such a way that the new assumptions could be relevant to the universe, but the conclusion that Gödel came to would no longer be relevant because the assumptions had changed? And there are a handful of relatively straightforward ways to do that. And frankly, I don't even haven't thought about it in detail in quite some time. But I remember going through and saying, aha, all we have to do is imagine a universe in which this is not true. And that universe could be our unit, like paracompact logic. Or, I mean, there are ways in which you can go beyond the limited set of assumptions that Gödel had. And so I more or less have convinced myself that Gödel's ideas need not imply that we will somehow fundamentally be in an undecidable situation when it comes to understanding the deep laws of the universe. It doesn't mean that Gödel's ideas might not apply. They could, but they don't have to. And with that realization, I became less interested in really puzzling, because now we're in a realm that's so esoteric and abstract relative to the kind of concrete problems like, what's the dark matter and what's the dark energy? And, you know, is there just a unified theory of the particles of matter that we have discovered? It just felt 20 steps removed from those kind of deep but really hands-on questions that I haven't spent a whole lot of time thinking about it since.
Speaking of time, do you believe time to be, well, maybe you don't, let's not say believe. When you were playing with some ideas earlier and you're saying, well, time may be emergent, do you also believe space to be emergent? Do you believe space-time itself is emergent?
Yeah, I mean, if time is emergent, it's hard for me to imagine that space is not emergent too. Again, anybody who's spent a little time thinking about the insights from Einstein on recognizes that space and time are so deeply and intricately interwoven into the fabric of space-time that sort of pulling one apart and imagining it has different properties, space and time have different properties, it's not impossible, but it does fly in the face of pretty much everything we've learned in the last 100 years. So I certainly do envision that if there's a realm of reality in which time does not apply because, as we were saying before, the conditions haven't yet allowed for a conception of time to emerge, the same would almost certainly be true of space. So the real way of saying it is there a realm of reality in which there's no conception of space-time? And it's hard for me to imagine what that is, but that's because I've got this brain that is constrained by what my ancestors did. And that brain is one that is so tied to a conception of reality in which space and time are the architecture within which events take place, that it's really hard for us to think about a reality in which there isn't space-time. And so I wish I could give some really good example or insight into what that would be like, but it would be some kind of reality in which the language that we use would not talk about when things are happening, and the language that we use would not talk about where things are happening. The language would somehow be beneath that, more fundamental than that. And it's not that scientists don't have some ideas for what this might be like. But I'd say that we do lack the deep picture and the deep story of how we would really articulate and navigate a reality absent space-time.
If you enjoyed this toe clipping, then the full video is linked in the description. Don't forget to follow Theories of Everything with Curt Jaimungal on Spotify for exclusive content and in-depth discussions. Your support on Spotify helps us grow and to reach more curious minds like yours. Check out the link in the description and join the Core Toe community on Spotify today. See you there.